friends, we shall continue our catechesis on the Blessed Mother. In the previous episodes, we considered Mary's being the Mother of Mercy and Forgiveness. We also recalled how she leads and shows to us the way, who is Jesus Himself. Today, let us review the Marian dogmas, or the definitive teachings of the Church about the Blessed Mother. There are four: Mary as the Mother of God, Mary's perpetual virginity, her Immaculate Conception, and her Assumption into Heaven. We shall reflect on the first two and reserve the others for next week. The first Marian dogma was proclaimed in the year 431. Mary is the Theotokos, the Mother or the Bearer of God. The Catechism tells us Mary is truly Mother of God since she is the Mother of the Eternal Son of God made man, who is God Himself. This teaching is indeed a corollary to our belief that Jesus is truly God and truly human. Mary is not just the mother of the human Jesus, but can rightly be called the Mother of God because in Jesus, the Word of God, the second person of the Trinity, became human. There is only one person. In the Gospels, we will find many references to Mary as the mother of Jesus. But during the Visitation, Elizabeth, the mother of John the Baptist, inspired by the Holy Spirit, addressed Mary as Mother of my Lord. Mary's hymn of rejoicing attributed her blessedness to the great things God had done to her. Such utterance rightly came from Elizabeth, who herself experienced God's mercy. In her old age and barrenness, she conceived John, who would go before Jesus to prepare His way. Every time we pray the Angelus and the Hail Mary, we pay tribute to Mary as the Mother of God, proclaimed by the words of the angel Gabriel and the prophetic exclamation of Elizabeth. We also praise the Triune God for the marvels of salvation. The second dogma, Mary is a Parthenos, ever virgin. She remained a virgin all her life. This belief in Mary's perpetual virginity has been professed in the Church as early as the 4th century. Citing Lumen Gentium, the Catechism tells us, Christ's birth did not diminish His mother's virginal integrity, but sanctified it. We recall the prophecy of Isaiah, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son. Because of the singular favor she received, the Virgin Mary conceived and gave birth to Jesus, the human face of God's mercy and salvation, the fulfillment of Isaiah's prophecy. Mary is the virgin handmaid of the Lord all her life, most pure, most chaste, most faithful, and most available to God and God's will. There you go, brothers and sisters. We will resume the discussion next week. May the ever-Virgin Mother of God pray for us and defend us from all evil.